guitar. It's a 1996 Gibson Custom Shop Historic 57 reissue Les Paul Custom. It's what a Les, I mean, it's a Les Paul Custom. Like, bold letters is what it's supposed to be. Weight on this guy is 9 pounds, 8 ounces. It's definitely got a 50s neck. The nut width on it is 1.71. First fret is 0.91 inches at the first fret. And then on the 12th fret, we're at 1.01 inches. It's chunky, man. I kind of felt, when I was playing it, I felt like it had like a, almost a V to it. I don't want to say, like, do you feel the how there's like no shoulders on that? Like how it's kind of V? The pickups on this guy are 57 Classics, ebony board. It's got the original case. There's no COA, but they didn't make COAs in 96, so that's why it doesn't have one. This thing, I always have these things because I always love them. So they're awesome. It's got it's mahogany. Mahogany top instead of maple.
Yeah. Customs in black.
That's what it's
so
a,
cool.
It's a custom, man. Yeah.
So much girth to them. Can I say that on YouTube?
You can say girth on YouTube. I really love the back of the shoulders. I mean, I like U-necks with huge shoulders on them, but I really like that neck too, with kind of the lack of the shoulders on it.
Yeah, it feels good. Weird with, I mean, a guitar that you haven't played before, you sit down and play, it always takes a minute to get kind of used to these, but this one, I haven't played this one much at all until right now, and man, it just feels good.
Yeah.
Feels like a Les Paul should, so, sweet.
All right, let's go over the condition on this one. I gave this guitar an 8 out of 10. It's just got some scratches, some dings, some finish checking, a little bit of tarnish to the hardware, and a little bit of wear, and then some clear coat fogging on the back of the guitar. So a little bit of wear in the back also. Let's get up close and check it out. Right off the bat, we can see that tarnish that I'm talking about. It's not bad, and it's nice and even and goes with the guitar. Light scratches, well, let's just call them scratches on that pick guard. And there's some of that finish checking that I was talking about. You can see it on the top. Yeah, it looks great. I mean, the mahogany top, the finish checking on this, you know, could be a real 57. No, it's not. Definitely not. Scroll through there, you can see a little bit of wear down there. And like I said, you can see all that finish checking. Ebony fingerboard, looks great. It's real ebony. Never thought I would be saying that. And let's check out the frets. The frets have like a very, very small amount of wear to them. I mean, we're talking like See what I'm talking about? Very, very small. Almost not existent. Okay, front of the headstock, looking good. Got some light scratches. You know, a little bit of checking around the logo, but that's all. I mean, it's a 96, what do you expect? Let's get this thing flipped over. I need that rack. You see that? Yeah, perfect. Serial number is 76358. Back of the headset looks good, no cracks or anything. And we've got a little bit, some scratches, a little bit dings here and there on the back. They're really, really minor though. Wear it there. And the back. There's our little bit of clear coat fogging that we were talking about. You could probably sand that out with like really fine grit sandpaper. I don't really care though, I'm just gonna leave it. That's just what it looks like. Just move for wear on the back. A little bit of wear. You just pick it up, unless it's spam.
No, it's not.
And let's keep checking. Like I said, the back got a little bit of wear on it, but overall it looks really good. The finish checking on this, it's great. There you have it.